The man arrested and accused of an attack at a BP gas station was released on bond. Kevin Williamson is charged with battery and had a bond set at $20,000. He's accused of beating a woman at a BP gas station on Monday in Arlington. This is graphic video showing that attack. The woman who was attacked said she heard Williamson say racist remarks. Williamson was arrested Friday night, had his first appearance Saturday, and then he was released Saturday night, we're told.
See, now, guess what some people will say? They released him because he white.
White privilege.
The average son person on the street don't know shit about the criminal justice system. So they thinking that, like, he got out. He got a bomb because if he was black, if a black person would have beat up a white woman, the cops would have shot him.
Even the ones that know why, even the ones that are in and out.
Yeah, they still talk that bullshit. Yeah, woke gangsters, that's what I call woke gangsters and shit. They do that shit. Yeah, they still talk that stupid shit.
Williamson's bond release has some people upset. Today, the new Black Panther Party held a protest at that same BP gas station. News for Jax reporter Bree Eisen.
So wait a second. The guy's out.
Did the guy attack a white lady or?
He attacked a black woman.
Oh, I didn't.
So he's out. He's free. And the Black Panther Party is going to protest. This guy, the guy who beat up their black queen, he's free. He's on the streets. And the Black Panther Party's going to protest. Even when I try to get on y'all level, it don't work. It's no fixing y'all, man. I'm trying to get on your level. All right, cool. I'm with the whole pro-black shit. All right, Black Panthers, okay. The guy's out. He's free. What we going to do? Protest at the gas station? What the fuck? We're going to get him to his house, right? And fuck him up, right? Because we the Black Panthers, right? Nah, man, we about to go down to the gas station and fuck up their business and try to, like, you know, slow their business down and boycott, give people to boycott the gas station. And here's the thing. How many of y'all before y'all started this channel, hit one if before you started on this channel that you thought you could fix this shit? Be honest. Like, you had, not saying you could personally fix it, but you thought your ideas. Like, you could come up with something that could fix it. Like, you had the, you know what I'm saying? Oh, man, I don't know how to fix it. Just do this, X, Y, Z. How many of y'all thought that before y'all joined this channel?
I mean, I do, but then when I hear the points you make very good points, and it's kind of like, yeah, I don't know. I don't know. It's tough.
It's going to take a lot. And I don't know if people have it in them.
I think the kids need to be sheltered from Jacob Blake, you know?
It's every level, though. You understand what I'm saying? Like, even like them, like the pro-blacky blacks. These ain't the thugs and criminals. Well, some of them, there are a lot of ex-thugs and shit.
Right.
They can't use logic. Like, they just, it's like, wait a second, man. The guys on the streets. We blackety-black militant motherfuckers. Let's go protest at the gas station.
Beating a woman at a BP gas station on Monday in Arlington. This is graphic video showing that attack. The woman who was attacked said she heard Williamson say racist remarks. Williamson was arrested Friday night, had his first appearance Saturday, and then he was released Saturday night, we're told. Williamson's bond release has some people upset. Today, the new Black Panther Party held a protest at that same BP gas station. News for Jax reporter Bree Isom joins us live from there. Bree, have you heard from them yet?
Yes, the new Black Panther Party tells me that they want hate crime charges added to those charges that Kevin Williamson is facing right now. They say that the woman said that he was saying some racist remarks to her when he walked into the gas station, and that's what they're out here protesting today.
Just
they want
she
those
alleged.
Crime charges added to those other charges that he's facing. They also don't believe
they're protesting that a random white guy said some racist stuff to a black
allegedly
man. Allegedly, because, yeah, definitely allegedly, but
right.
Let's say he did. Protesting that at the
right.
place where it happened. So they're going to shut down the business at the place where it happened.
Yeah.
Like,
but you know,
there has
just like they're going to burn down the Wendy's right. or.
Well, Chicago's been doing that. The city of Chicago, where there was a shooting in one of the in the west side, a rough area, right? They gunned the guy down and the city shut down the gas station. That mass shooting in downtown with the McDonald's, they shut the McDonald's down. So now the Sun Man can't act right, so we're going to punish the business owners.
Right? I'd imagine they had electrical issues after all the bullets went through something.
Right. Right, but think about that. In the Sun community, they complain we don't have shit. They don't no businesses, no investment.
You burned them down already. What do you expect?
Well, you're shutting them down when the Sun Man can't help but gun each other down, and everybody are in the vicinity. So what do you want? What the fuck do you want?
Yeah,
I don't even think they know.
Yeah, exactly, because. If we were in our own society, we wouldn't have gas stations. We wouldn't have grocery stores. We wouldn't have none of that shit. So this is all shit that's like foreign to our psyche, to us, like our brain. It's just like we do it because we're here, but we don't understand the importance of it because it's not an institution or a thing that our minds would create.
Say that the woman said that he was saying some racist remarks to her when he walked into the gas station, and that's what they're out here protesting today. They want those hate crime charges added to those other charges that he's facing. They also don't believe that he should be walking around free on those streets. And now you can see some people gathered from the New Black.
So of all the people that the murderers that have been let out on bond in the country, it's no snitching with that, but this is snitching. Think about this, Wicked. If a Sun Man had shot that woman, right? That woman got into an argument with the Sun Team. The Sun Team shoots her, and he gets out on bond. Do they protest?
Crickets.
Hell no. No one wants to get shot, brother.
Right. So the theory that white supremacy and white people are so scary and they're the biggest threat to black people, they obviously not fearing any retaliation.
Right.
No.
And black folks are so weak. Black folks are so powerless.
Yeah.
Like that one basketball interview that she did where the two white dudes were doing the interview and they were like, their words have no power.
Good.
It's like, come on, man.
That was good.
You kidding me?
That was good. White boy can't jump.
Now you can see some people gathered from the New Black Panther Party behind me. They're kind of just telling people at this gas station
people.
What happened and what.
Two people for the Black Panther.
Two people. What does he say? Black voters matter.
God, Jesus Christ! You know, this is embarrassing.
What do you call them? All reenactors? They reenacting the civil rights.
Right, yeah, civil rights reenactors. These fucking guys. God damn.
This is more shameful than storming Area 51.
Yeah, this is embarrassing. Like, if I was one of these guys, I'd have my shades growing for a fucking year. This is embarrassing, man.
Party behind me, they're kind of just telling people at this gas station what happened and what they think needs to happen. Now they're also telling me that they want to boycott this gas station because they say it has a long history of some racial incidences here. Now this is what the New Black Panther Party was telling me. I also talked to one of the individuals that said no woman of any race should be attacked.
Think about it. There's Trump rallies with 100,000 people in attendance. Nobody.
Biden can't even fill his little circles
But no media coverage, right? The media completely ignores all the Trump rallies all over the country. You wouldn't even know that there are Trump rallies.
We'll just watch it on YouTube.
Right? You wouldn't even know that, right? That there's Trump rallies every week. But two Black Panthers.
Packed like this.
What is important to understand, this is a woman that was brutally attacked by a man. That is unacceptable, whether she's Black or white.
Oh, four. Did you see this one right here? And back here, he back there.
Oh, high, shit. And the cut.
He looks like that one dude from ESPN.
He's the one with the gun.
Oh, God.
Of any race should be attacked like this.
What is important to understand, this is a woman that was brutally attacked by a man. That is unacceptable, whether she's Black or white, here in the city of Jacksonville across America. What just happened in Buffalo is indicative of the whole racial climate in America. But for a woman of this magnitude, as you just said, to be attacked, to be brutally beaten, she was being punched by a man in such a way that every woman in the city of Jacksonville, whether she's Black or white, should be out here protesting over the next few days, that this type of behavior is unacceptable from Mr. Williamson and anyone.
Now, the community this guy comes from is fucking people getting killed every day.
He made more sense than Al Sharpton at
I was
Buffalo.
Thinking that.
He gave more ground than Al Sharpton did.
That's a good standard to have, but have it for your community as well, motherfucker.
You would think that this guy was from a fucking, like, area where, like, he had never seen, like, oh, my God, his sensitivity, his fucking, you know, so he's just so, his sensibilities are so tender. Like, he's from a place where, oh, my God, we don't do this type of stuff. This guy's from a place where people are murdered routinely.
For nothing.
Women are shot. Like, this is the same city where that
podcaster?
They got shot, like, 80 times at the gas station. I did a video about that a couple weeks ago. This is where she was from. This is where all the kids and teens got killed. Like, right. A bunch of teens.
Oh, forget the guns. The violence.
Right. Just the fights and shit.
Regardless of race, creed, or color, to abuse, to attack, or abuse a woman. That's somebody's mother. That's somebody's sister. That's somebody's daughter. It is wrong. And we asked Melissa Nelson, as he said, to stand up. And we demand justice. This is a hate crime, Mike Williamson. Mike Williams, hate crime, no question about it.
As you could hear there, he's asking the state attorney, Melissa Nelson, to prosecute Kevin Williamson with a hate crime because they say that the woman said that she heard him say racist remarks to her when he walked into that gas station. I'm reporting live in Jacksonville. Bree Isom, Channel 4, the local station.
It's tiresome. Like, I'm embarrassed, man. I'm so embarrassed, man. Like, what is shit?
Chicago police are investigating after a woman says she was abducted, raped, and chained up inside a vacant Southside house for days. Good evening, everyone. I'm Jackie Bang.
And I'm Tamon Bradley. Thanks for joining us. WGN's Jewel Hillary is live at Area 2 Police Headquarters on the far South Side with the story. Jewel.
Hi, good evening, Jackie and Tamon. Well, a 36-year-old woman tells us that she was held captive inside of an abandoned West Pullman home for 4 to 5 days. She was finally freed on Saturday evening after a local community activist heard her cries for help and called police.
Just him hearing my cry, my call, because I've been doing that for days.
This 36-year-old woman, who we are keeping anonymous, says she was walking to a neighborhood store early last week when she ran into a man who she's talked to before.
And I ended up bumping into him, and he was like, you know, come here for a minute.
That's when the woman says the unthinkable happened.
He just grabbed me, and I'm trying to fight him, but can't fight him.
From there, the woman says the man took her into this abandoned house in the 119th block of South Eggleston.
He raped me twice. Then he sat up there. He left me up in there handcuffed and chained.
The woman says the man, who she thinks is in his 60s, took her to the basement and then dragged her to the attic.
Ankle chained up, handcuffed, just in there, just bounded.
Days after crying out for help, on Saturday night around 5:30.
As I got closer, I'm hearing boom, 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 help. And that's what made me call the police.
Once he heard the cries for help, Hands Around the Hundred community activist Antoine Dobine, also known as D-Ice, went live on Facebook.
I just located a girl inside this house. The police say she chained up.
Before police arrived on the scene, Antoine says he saw a man come from the vacant house.
He's got on a blue jean corduroy jacket. I don't know what type of pants. I'm going to say he's about 5'8", 5'7".
After police rescued the woman from the house, she went to a local hospital to be checked out. She says she is filled with gratitude to Antoine for stepping in.
He could have ignored me, but he heard me and he helped me. I'm just blessed. I'm truly blessed.
In the aftermath of what's happened, people who grew up in this neighborhood question what could be inside the other abandoned properties nearby and hope good can come from this tragic incident.
Let's open the abandoned homes. Let's walk through the homes. Let's do a search. Let's lock it back up. Just make sure everything is okay.
Antoine is asking for money to help turn the deserted properties into resources for the...
Okay, but what about the guy who did it? Like, think about that. None of them have spoken about the guy who did it. They want to open up all the... Do we understand, like, money?
It'd probably be cheaper to demolish them.
No, but just think about the money it would take, the resources it would take to go through and search every abandoned house in Chicago.
Yeah.
It's a lot.
Like, sometimes it just frustrates me. Like, they're not talking about finding the guy who did this particular act. They want to search all the...
Start small first.
The community.
Returning citizens from incarceration need a place to stay. Our mental health people need a place to stay to get back on their feet.
As for the woman rescued from the house, she says she is grateful to be alive and doesn't want what's happened to her to happen to anyone else.
I believe that he will strike again. So, I mean, I want him caught.
At last check, no offenders were in custody. Reporting live outside of the Area 2 Police Center on the far...
They said what?
At last check with police, no offenders were in custody.
No offenders.
Good morning. The protest began just as parents were starting to drop off their children for school. The group here says it wants the community to see this show of solidarity, this stand against racism and hatred. Those here also are demanding to know why there has not been an arrest in this case 10 days after the discovery of the three nooses. The organization Ex-Cons for Community and Social Change is leading the...
So the Ex-Cons for Community and Social Change demanding that some guy who did some...
Just wait until it's a bunch of black people. It's just a hoax.
Of course it was a hoax, but what I'm saying is just the fact that this is a community in shambles. You got a bunch of ex-cons, a bunch of guys. When these guys were young, they was the fucking little Dirks and the little Chief Keefs and the King Vons of their neighborhood. They went to jail for a long time, came home, you know what I'm saying?
Right. And now they're acting.
Dude's got a nice watch on him.
Got a homicide. They're near my
this guy right here.
Homicide.
Yeah, I see the stories of him. Yeah.
The school that they're going to in Evanston, beautiful suburb. If black kids are going there, they're blessed to be going there.
Right.
They need to be fucking. Right. You know what I'm saying? You already know.
Yeah. This Evanston is the suburbs. It's where like the kids that would have excelled in the Chicago public schools would have got a scholarship or something to come out there, some shit. Yeah, and now here come the ex-con grown men to come shit all over the place. Like, they don't have to do this. They could just focus on something going on in the hood.
Right.
They coming out
shit
here.
That matters.
Yeah, shit that matters.
Violence disruptors.
Right. They coming out here to fucking just this is hating. This seems like hating a little bit. Like, they hating on them young kids because they had a chance to do something that they didn't have.
Days after the discovery of the three nooses, the organization Ex-Cons for Community and Social Change is leading the protests outside Haven Middle School. Some Evanston parents and residents are also here. Some parents found the nooses May 13th hanging from a tree between Haven School and Kingsley Elementary School. That day, some Haven students...
Hold on. But, so, if I'm black and I see a noose, it's like, it's about me.
Right. Like, I never understood that.
It ain't about the Juice Crew.
No, but why can't it just be a noose?
Why got to hang everybody back in there?
Because they were only designed. No, they were only designed by the slave catchers for the black people.
Oh my God!
There were no white people that ever got hung from nooses. No Jewish people. Like, it was only
no black. Irish.
No Irish.
Well, I'm just trying to take it a step further than that. Like, okay, why does it have to hold all that connotation?
Take it so personally.
Why can't it just a whole noose? Why does it have to be like instantly? Oh my God! Racism. Why can't this be a noose?
Maybe it's a subconscious guilt. Maybe they feel like some niggas deserve to be hung.
That's it right there.
They like shit, man. You've exposed our whole inner conscience. We know how fucked that we are out here.
Damn.
Shit. Man.
Also staged a sitting against staff changes proposed for next school year. District 65's superintendent says in a letter to parents that the discovery of the nooses was a hate crime. He called it an outwardly racist act. Protesters say they want transparency when it comes to the investigation. They also want to meet with Evanston Mayor Daniel Biss.
It's not enough.
This group of niggas want to meet with the fucking mayor over this shit.
Man.
They got a program.
These are thoughts, man. These are community thoughts, man. This is some poetic shit, man. These niggas don't even feel guilty. I mean, I respect, like, all right, trying to, you know what I mean? I get it, and you want to do, but, like, over some fucking nooses, you niggas is corny, son. I'm tired.
Like, these kinds have met with newer co-players. It's an office that oversees Chicago police, and these guys have met with them, so they're legitimate, I guess, somehow.
This shit is sad, man. Like, they're demanding to meet with the mayor because three nooses were allegedly found by some parents. So now these guys, a group of guys from Chicago, ex-cons, all fucking did 15, 20 years in the prison, coming out there and demanding to meet with the mayor. What the fuck?
And making shit awkward for the parents dropping out their kids, dog. That's right. Just awkward. Right. We know who did that. We know who put the we know who did it, dog.
Right.
Don't they have cameras out there?
Right. They know who the fuck did this shit.
When it comes to the investigation, they also want to meet with Evanston Mayor Daniel Biss.
It's not enough black men or black individuals out here for our babies to latch on to. So
oh my
they attend
God.
To like.
What?
I cannot, man.
There's not enough fathers in children's lives, so you're going to make a difference in children's lives by protesting against some nooses?
No, but he's not even there. He won't get quiet of shit. He's not saying that. He's not talking about fathers.
It's the black men.
He's just talking about it's not enough black people. This is a white town, Evanston, right? Somebody give me the demographic.
Right.
It's not enough black people. When he says babies, he's talking about the students. He's not talking about real babies. He's talking about the students at the school. They're babies. They're the babies he's talking about. Somebody got a lot of noise going on in the background, but yeah. He said, God damn. God damn, shit, fucking crazy. And the men they supposed to latch on to is ex-cons.
not enough black men or black individuals out here for our babies to latch on to. So they attend to, like, you know, get more familiar with other cultures and customs. You know, we want to let them know you all have a culture and a way of living too. And
oh my God. Your culture, way of living is trash. Like, literally. No, these kids got a way. They got a way to this town. Oh my God, they about to ruin this fucking town.
The ex-con way of life.
It's not enough black men or black individuals out here for our babies to latch on to. So they attend to, like, you know, get more familiar with other cultures and customs. You know, we want to let them know you all have a culture and a way of living too, and it's okay today. And three nooses will not be accepted where they have to actually learn. This is a place of education.
Every gender, race, everyone matters. And this is my town. I don't want this kind of publicity, you know? I want to be proud of my town.
Bitch, you throwing everybody under the bus.
I don't want this kind of violence coming to my town. I don't want these super gremlins coming in.
Hey, somebody dropped them.
They're racist.
Somebody dropped them.
What's the demographic?
Yeah, 16%. Somebody in the chat said it's 16% sun, 66% glider.
Oh, that's a lot of sun, man.
That's a lot of sun.
No. I think it's less than that. Somebody else put different ones up there. I thought it was like 1.8 sun.
Nah, I looked it up too. I think that's
oh,
right.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, on the census.
Okay. It's still a great suburb, dude. Nothing's going on over there. Nothing.
Yeah, so maybe maybe it's the well, it's about to happen now. This right here is a bad sign because when they start doing this, what happens next is they start relaxing standards. They start, you know, like they start doing everything.
Showing favoritism to the sun.
Yeah, they start checking their profiling meter, whatever the fuck is the way I'm looking for.
Well, yeah, no, they start saying that the school doesn't have enough black students. So now you gotta bring more black people out there. And that's never gonna be. The more black people out there is just going to lead to more crime. And then the test, they got to get rid of testing because, you know, testing is racist. So they got to get rid of that. And school just slowly erodes. The white parents take their kids out of that school and put them somewhere else. And then that school becomes more and more sunny. And then, this glider right here, this woman is a wretch. She's a scumbag. Because why would she stand up for a town like, I don't know about this one, man. With a noose?
She's gonna run. She'll be the first one running.
Yeah, like a noose? I don't know. I would wait for the investigation to come out and see what happens because we don't even. Like, where all the nooses in the past? So just three nooses just popped up. That just sounds weird. I'm gonna let the investigation. Instead, she went and threw everybody under the fucking bus.
Gets defensive immediately.
Yeah, she
wasn't me. She said it.
That was a
every
shit
gender,
thing.
Race, everyone matters. And this is my town. I don't want this kind of publicity. You know, I want to be proud of my town. And the country, you know, I mean, everything has to change. It has to change.
Oh my God.
Yeah, we have reached.
What the fuck is she? Everything has to change. Because she.
Everything. And you'll be moving out. You'll be the first one moving out, lady. What do you mean?
She looked like she got means.
She will be gone. This woman. These people are irritated. These people, they're exhausted, man. Like,
yes.
But I mean, we reached out
to the school superintendent, Evanston Police, and the mayor for a response. There is also a school board meeting this evening, and a lot of parents here told us that lots of parents plan to show up and speak at that session.
Oh my God! So now they got a school board meeting. All the white parents gonna come out there and like talk about how they're not racist, even though everybody else is. because they found a new, so that must be that racist, but I'm not racist. And the black parents gonna come out there and say, what we gotta do to get accepted? Every look like what this town is so oh god.
And then they started an affinity program for the black students, and they have a black students association.
And then they gotta lie to them. So the men, they can't say the truth. They gotta sit there and take it.
And I bet 90% of their suspensions at that school were fucking the black kids.
Yeah, their gun memorial is that way.
In Evanston? They have a gun memorial.
Yeah, it's small. It's not a lot going on, but it's sunny as fuck.
Wow.
Again, with more pushback against the city's new curfew orders.
Tonight, a group of teens gathered outside City Hall demanding a say in the city's summer safety strategy. And WGN's Jenna Barnes is joining us live downtown with more details. Jenna?
Yeah, guys, today the city council delayed a vote on the mayor's curfew change, but a group of young people came here to ask them to vote no when that time comes. These kids and young adults are part of the racial justice organization Communities
United. These are the good kids that aren't fucking out, fucking wilding on the, the magic night, aren't wilding out downtown in the loop.
Jumping on cars and shit.
Jumping on cars. These are the kids that aren't doing that, and they're fucking out there. That's so fucking sick. These are the kids.
They're victims to the
They got the liberal arts degrees. And
these are the kids that can't go outside in the neighborhood. These kids can't go outside. Right. These kids can't go outside and play a fucking a Chicago day mood.
Hell no.
I mean, they could, but, you know.
Nah, they can't.
They're not going to last five minutes.
Young adults are part of the racial justice organization Communities United, and they held a die-in outside City Hall, saying Mayor Lori Lightfoot's plan to move the curfew for minors back 1 hour on weekends from 11 p.m. to 10 p.m. won't have much of an impact on their lives, at least they say not a positive one. Instead, they're asking to be a part of the conversation to create programs for youth downtown, and they're calling for more mental health resources and job opportunities. Those are
why are these kids talking about mental?
They don't know it. They don't know jack shit. Guaranteed.
These series of stories, man, are really just like
depressing.
Yeah.
It's a big bowl of sad.
In Chicago, where people are being fucking murdered all the time. And shot.
That's the next sweatshirt. Big bowl of sad. And that's the next t-shirt design. Yeah.
The thing they choose to protest is the one thing that actually may help, having sun teams off the street earlier.
Right.
It will help crime at that hour. So if sun teams got to go be in the house by 10 o'clock, the 11 o'clock crime rate will go down drastically.
Dramatically, yeah.
Hey, I don't know if you heard about this, but the first day, the curfew at 10 p.m. was enacted on Thursday. A juvie, a 13-year-old, was shot by CPD at 10:40. 10:40 p.m. So 40 minutes after the first day of curfew,
damn,
a 13-year-old was shot in a stolen car.
Wow. There's no solutions.
Are the things these kids say will make a difference.
We want to stop the violence too, but in order to do that, we can't just set restrictions on youth lives. We got to add more resources to help them better in the future.
And he says that as
more resources. More
we need midnight basketball.
More of the white citizens' tax dollars.
That's what we've been trained to say.
Yeah. He said that with no passion. It was kind of just like, he just said it like a robot.
There's no explanation. Yeah, it was just a talking point.
Yeah, it's like, we need more. What the fuck is wrong with this community?
Meanwhile, he's probably in two after-school programs and a sports program.
Every meal he's had the last 5 years is from a food bank or a food program. Yeah, this shit is fucking crazy.
And he says that as someone who has lost a brother to gun violence. The city council is now set to vote on this.
This kid's brother got killed.
Not surprised
at all.
Resources to help him better in the future.
And he says that as someone who has lost a brother to gun violence. The city council is now set to vote on this curfew ordinance Wednesday. We're live at City Hall. Jenna Barnes, WGN News.